हेलो, वी आर डिस्कसिंग अबाउट सॉल्यूशंस फॉर गेट 2011 ईसीई पेपर एंड वी आर डिस्कसिंग अबाउट द टॉपिक ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन डिवाइसेस। वी आर डिस्कसिंग ए सीरीज ऑफ 2 मार्क्स क्वेश्चंस। दिस इज द फोर्थ सेकंड 2 मार्क्स क्वेश्चन अपीयर्ड इन गेट 2011। इट्स ए कॉमन डाटा क्वेश्चन। फर्स्ट यू विल कंसीडर द फर्स्ट वन, लेटर विल गो फॉर द सेकंड वन। सो फर्स्ट यू विल सी द कॉमन डाटा। The channel resistance for an n-channel JFET shown below is 600 ohms. When the full channel thickness of 10 micrometer is available for conduction, the bulletin voltage for the gate P plus N junction is minus 1 volt. When the gate to source voltage is 0 volts, the channel is depleted by 1 micrometer on each side due to the bulletin voltage. And hence the thickness available for conduction is only 8 micrometers. Read the question again. The common data given as channel resistance of an n-channel JFET is 600 ohms when the full channel thickness of 10 micrometers is available for conduction. The bulletin voltage is minus 1 volt when VGS is 0. And the channel is depleted by 1 micrometer on each side due to this built-in voltage. So that the thickness available for conduction is only 8 micrometers instead of full channel thickness of 10 micrometers. So you need to calculate the channel resistance when VGS is equal to 0. A. 480 ohms. B. 600 ohms. C. 750 ohms. D. 1000 ohms. The right answer for this question is 750 ohms. We are going to calculate channel resistance. The final answer is 750 ohms. We see the details. For this question, you must understand the operation of n-channel JFET. Look at this one. This is the JFET given. This P plus and P plus are going to be two gates of n-channel JFET. And these two gates are going to be tied together. This is what? The two gates are going to be tied together. Whatever the voltage you are applying externally for one gate, that is going to be applied to two gates. And in between two gates, there is a channel region. That is, an n-type semiconductor is there, which act as channel. One side of that one is drain, the other side of that one is act as source. So the current flows from drain to source, but how much current is flowing from drain to source is controlled by VGS. Assume that one. If you are applying more positive voltage, VGS. If you are applying positive voltage, at that time PN junction will become forward bias. It is of no use. Always JFET is going to be under reverse bias. So gate source junction of JFET is always reverse bias to increase the input impedance, which is nothing but main requirement for ideal voltage amplifier. An ideal voltage amplifier is going to be having infinite input impedance, but BJT doesn't satisfy this condition because its input junction is always forward bias, emitter bias junction. So to overcome that limitation, FET has come. In FET, always input junction is reverse bias. Under reverse bias, we know the resistance is very, very high, so that we are going to achieve the ideal resistance, which is infinite. So always VGS value, what you will apply for n-channel FET is always negative. So even though here we are writing as VGS increases, that is negatively. Okay, so write that one, as VGS increases negatively. Depletion region width increases, because whenever you are applying negative voltage for P side and PN junction of this side and PN junction of this side, both PN junctions will get reverse bias as you are applying VGS negative, and as you are increasing that voltage, it will become more and more reverse biased. We know that one, under reverse bias, depletion region width is more. So more reverse bias means more depletion region width. So as VGS increases negatively, depletion region width W of both PN junctions increases. By that time, depletion region is going to be increases, depletion region increases more into lightly doped site than heavily doped site, so that depletion region more penetrates into N site instead of P plus site. So it will be penetrating into the channel, the depletion width. Here also the depletion region is penetrating into the channel, so that effective channel width is going to be reduces. So effective channel width is going to be reducing. Whenever effective channel width is reducing, so that the portion allowed for the current flow is going to be reduces. That implies drain current is reduces. So that drain current is reducing is nothing but channel current is reducing. Channel current is reducing is nothing but channel resistance is increasing. So this is going to be happening. As gate to source voltage negatively increases, depletion region width across both PN junctions increases, which reduces the effective channel width, so that effective drain current is reduces, that is channel resistance is increases. From this we can conclude channel resistance is inversely proportional to effective channel width. If effective channel width is large, at that time channel resistance is small. If effective channel width is small, at that time channel resistance is large. So channel resistance and effective channel width are going to be inversely proportional. So remove the proportionality and you will get proportionality constant K. RC is equal to K into 1 by T effective. From this one, if you calculate K, at that time you can calculate any RC for given effective thickness. So from the information given in the problem, we will calculate the value of K now. So before going for K, just how to calculate full channel thickness. Full channel thickness is nothing but effective channel thickness plus 2 times of width of depletion region, because both PN junctions are present. T effective plus 2 times of W, full channel thickness is. So the given information is, when no gate voltage is applied, that is when gate is open, remember it. When gate voltage is applied, when no gate voltage is applied, gate is open. So full channel thickness available. Full channel thickness is 10 micrometers. And since gate is open, there is no depletion region is formed. So that W is equal to 0. T effective is nothing but 10 micrometers. And channel resistance is given as 600 ohms at that point. We can calculate the proportionality constant K as RC into T effective, that is 6000 ohm micrometers. And given the information of built-in voltage F minus 1 volt, when VGS is equal to 0, the depletion region formed at both PN junctions is 1 micrometer. Now you need to calculate channel resistance at VGS is equal to 0. So first calculate effective channel thickness. Effective channel thickness is full channel thickness minus 2 times of W. So 10 minus 2 into 1, which is nothing but 8 micrometers. This is also given in the problem. So channel resistance when VGS is equal to 0 is RC with T effective of 8 micrometers you are going to calculate. So RC is equal to K into 1 by T effective. That is 6000 ohm micrometers into 1 by 8 micrometers, which is equal to 750 ohms. So channel resistance when VGS is equal to 0 is nothing but 750 ohms. Right answer for this question is 750 ohms.